to talk about fall events, so I want to make sure that I at least tell you a couple of things that are going on because they're happening this weekend. So, you know, Autism Speaks does walks all over the country, and these are wonderful events that they raise money, and they're really important events, I think, for so many different reasons. But for families, it gives you an opportunity to go. Usually there's a resource fair attached to each one of the walks. It's a place to go and meet your community and to fact find, and usually there's somebody at the resource fair that's giving out bags, but I encourage you to go to one that's close to you at least once a year and pick up at least one piece of paper from every single booth. And it's an opportunity for you to meet people, for your child to be out. Nobody has expectations about how your child is supposed to behave when you're there. They're really wonderful events, and there are a bunch of them that are happening this weekend. So, in California, tomorrow, the 15th, Modesto, California, the Central Valley Autism Speaks. In Fort Wayne, Indiana, tomorrow, you're walking for autism. Woohoo for you. The Greater Hudson Valley is having one in Suffern, New York. Las Vegas is having theirs tomorrow in Las Vegas, Nevada. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, but we'll talk about the autism walk. Okay, and it's a big weekend there. So St. Louis, Missouri is having their autism walk tomorrow. And on Sunday, Cranford, New Jersey is hosting the North Central New Jersey. Yay for New Jersey. Love that. So those are wonderful events. Those are great places to go. They're free. You don't have to have fundraised to be able to attend. They are meant to be supportive of families who are on the spectrum. So take your children out to those. Connect with the people who are there, and give your child an opportunity to have the experience of being there with all those people that are supporting them and supporting you. So a wonderful, wonderful thing. And a lot of those, you know, I am from the East Coast originally. So to our friends in Jersey and to our friends in Suffern, you know, yay. And now I live out here. So we've got sort of the whole mix. We've got East Coast, West Coast, and Indiana in the middle. And next weekend, though, it's going to be Houston, Texas. And there are some more. Let me scroll through and tell you what some of these other cities are that are going to be next weekend. Next weekend is the National Walk in Washington, D.C. And then the last weekend in October, Pittsburgh is having theirs in Allison Park and Baltimore, Maryland, and Sullivan County in New York in Loch Sheldrake. What a wonderful name for a place. And can't forget, Arizona is having theirs on the 30th. So great, great events happening around the country in the month of October. There are so many fall events that you can go to that are local, and you know, take your child as well to events that are not specified for autism, but fall events. Just make sure that you do it in small amounts so that they don't get overwhelmed and that you don't have huge expectations, but that you just go. And you will, I think what's wonderful about these kinds of things, we have a pumpkin patch that's very close to our house, and we make a point of going every single year and taking pictures on the same area of pumpkins every single year. And it has become a little bit of a benchmark for us to be able to notice each and every year. And it reminds me where we were the year before and how much progress has been made. And yeah, you know, when he was three, it wasn't the easiest thing. And he was running around and he was stimming. And, you know, I've got video of that, and it was maybe difficult for us, but it became a point in time we videotaped, and to be able to look the next year and see that he was talking was wonderful, and to see the next year that he was, you know, having friends that he was playing with up until this year, you know, where we're there and we're functioning with everybody else. But I can remember those years in a way that it's different now to be able to look at those with those memory and say, yep, he was stimming and we survived it. It's great to have that to remember by, these milestones that we can look back and say, okay, I remember exactly where we were a year ago, and we're in a better place. It's very reinforcing.